yesterday we already learned about the definition of interhalogen compounds. What are the interhalogen compounds? We already learned. The interhalogen compounds or compound is a compound formed by combination of atoms of the different halogens. Now, the halogens in themselves form compounds, and always that halogen is anion or is negatively charged ion which have the more electronegativity value. Remember that. And the halogen which have somewhat more electropositive or less electronegativity value is the cation, that is the positive ion. Now see, depending, now consider the classification of the interhalogen compounds. Depending on their composition, they are classified into four main types. Now here, in the type, I here write the general formula of interhalogen compounds. See there. Now, X dash. Now this X is the more electropositive halogen, and X dash is the more electronegative halogen. X is more electropositive halogen and X dash is more electronegative halogen. That means the electronegativity of this X is less and electronegativity of X dash is more. Now see the examples of X dash. Cl where fluorine is more electronegative and chlorine is less electronegative. Again BrF. In that also, fluorine is more electronegative, bromine is less electronegative. Now, these X-dash type interhalogen compounds are also called as the, that is, monohalides of that of the electropositive halogen. For example, this ClF is called as the chlorine monofluoride. Then, what will be the name of BrF? Bromine monofluoride. What is the name of BrCl? Bromine monofluoride. What is the name of ICl? Iodine monofluoride and iodine monobromide. Mono means only one halide, that is H dash having the more electronegativity value. Now the general formula of all these types are generally given as in this way. See here. X dash here. Now what is N there? N is the number of more electronegative atoms. And X is the electropositive halogen and X dash is the more electronegative halogen. Now this second type. Now this second type X dash is there. Sorry, X dash 3. That means, see here, this X dash 3 or this X dash is also the more electronegative, that is the fluorine in all the three examples. Now this is the chlorine trifluoride, bromine trifluoride, iodine trifluoride. Now next type is the X dash 5. Here also this X dash is more electronegative and the examples are also here all the fluorides as that of the trihalide. In trihalide there is also all fluorides because fluorine is more electronegative, so it always becomes the anion, that is the negative ion. So it is the chlorine pentafluoride, bromine pentafluoride, iodine pentafluoride. And the last type is X-7. There is only one example, iodine heptafluoride. Now see, in all these types, if you count the total number of halogens, they are always even. Now see, 1 plus 1, 2. Here is the 2. Now 3 plus 1, 4. Total number of halogens are 4 means even. 5 plus 1, 6. And 7 plus 1, 8. Now this is one of the characteristic of this inter-halogen compound that their total number of halogen atoms are always even into that. Now, see the general formula again. Now, the general formula X H dash here, where X is the halogen having larger size. See here, this fluorine is larger than the size of fluorine. So, X is always larger size. See, in all the example you found here, that the X have the larger size than the H dash. And the halogen having larger size, X is the halogen having larger size and more electropositive than the H dash. And H dash is the halogen having smaller size and it is more electronegative. Now see here, the H dash is the fluorine here in CLF, which is less in size than fluorine. Here also fluorine is less in size. And all these compounds of all types of the inter-halogen compounds, we are seeing that the negative, that is the electronegative, more electronegative halogen is always in a smaller size. Now, let us see the general characteristics of inter-halogen compounds. The first of characteristic is that there are totally six, may be asked for 3 marks because there are totally 6 characteristics. Very simple. The first one is inter-halogen compound considered as the halide of X. Halide of X means, now see here, this is the fluoride of chlorine. So it is the chlorine monofluoride. The last, that is the second halogen, becomes halide here. Bromine monofluoride. Bromine monochloride. That means the H dash always becomes halide. So they say that the inter-halogen compound is considered as the halide of X. Halide of X means chlorine fluoride here. That means in Marathi, chlorine's fluoride. That means chlorine's fluoride. That means chlorine monofluoride. So X, it is the fluoride of this X, that is the chloride. Sorry, chlorine. So it is the always the that is inter-halogen compound considered as always the halide of X. For example, CLF means chlorine monofluoride in this way. Now the second characteristic is that the total number of halogen atoms in the inter-halogen compound are always even. I already tell you about that. The total number of halogen atoms are even. Remember that. And give only one example. Now in CLF3, they have the 4 atoms. Here also give the example. In every characteristic, example must be necessary. Now the properties of the inter-halogen derivatives, that is the compounds, are always intermediate or in between the halogen from which they are made. For example, now suppose this is the chlorine, which is a pale yellowish green in color, and this is the fluorine, which is colorless. Now what happened? When chlorine and fluorine form the inter-halogen compound, the properties of these both mix into that. That means the property of this CLF is intermediate between the property of, that means the color of this CLF may be very very pale yellowish, and not it is a pale yellowish green or colorless. In this way, the properties, every property, this is about the color, but every properties of the inter-halogen compounds are always in intermediate or in between the halogen atom from which they are made. Very simple. Now the central halogen exhibit, that means show, exhibit means show, the different oxidation state in their different inter-halogen compounds. Now see here. Now this fluorine have in this compound, this fluorine have +1 oxidation state, because this fluorine have -1 oxidation state. Now the, see the another inter-halogen compound of fluorine is this. Now here, what is the oxidation state of chlorine? +3, because fluorine always have -1 oxidation state. So there are the 3 fluorine. So totally minus 3. To balance minus 3, this chlorine must have plus 3 oxidation. Here the oxidation state of chlorine is plus 1. But here the oxidation of chlorine is plus 3. Now again see in this compound. Chlorine pentachloride. Yes, plus 5. Because total oxidation state of this 5 chloride ion minus 5. To balance for that plus 5. And in this way, similarly all these halogens in their different compound show the different oxidation state. That is the fourth characteristic of interhalogen pairing. Now the fifth characteristic is that the number of H dash atom is always odd. Yes. Now see in all these example or see in the time. Here is the H dash atom is 1. Here 3. Total number are even. Total number of halogen atoms are even. But only the H dash are odd. H dash have the odd number. Remember that. Very. Now see in all these the H dash here 1, 3, 5 and 7. All I have the odd number of H dash halogen. Now the last one is that all these interhalogen compounds are dimagnetic. That means there is no unpaired electron into that. So they are the dimagnetic. Their magnetic property, that is they are dimagnetic, not paramagnetic. Now this is about the characteristics. Now let us see the another again some properties of interhalogen compounds. Now let us study the methods of preparation of interhalogen compounds. Methods of preparation of interhalogen compounds. Now first method is by direct combination. When we directly combine the two different halogens, but both must be in equal amount. For example, if we have to prepare the X dash type of interhalogen, that is such as ClF, then equal amount of chlorine and equal amount of fluorine are heated directly at 523 Kelvin in the copper vessel. Tube of copper is there and both gases are in equal amount come in contact at 523 Kelvin and there is preparation of this chlorine monofluoride is formed. Now again if we want to prepare the iodine monochloride, only just add in equal amount or combine in equal amount iodine and chlorine in the presence of both strong acids such as hydrochloric acid and nitric acid. And just boil them. Then you obtain the iodine monochloride. Now this is also the XH dash type of interhalogen compound. The third XH dash type of interhalogen compound is bromine monochloride. Now they only just are in contact with each other in the equal amount. There is no requirement of any catalyst or temperature is there. And directly there is the formation of bromine monochloride is formed there. Now if we want to prepare the XH3 dash type of interhalogen compound by direct combination method, they are also formed by direct combination method. Which type of interhalogen compounds? XH3 dash of interhalogen compound. For example, chlorine trifluoride. Chlorine trifluoride. Bromine trifluoride, iodine trifluoride. But what condition is there? Here is not in the equal amount for preparation of that is the trihalides of interhalogen compound. There are always the most electronegative halogen in excess. Must be in excess. Now see. Excess means they must be three times their volume is more than the more electropositive halogen. Now this Cl2 plus thrice F2 forms twice ClF3. Now balance the reaction. There are the 6 chlorine atoms and 2 chlorine atoms. So in twice ClF3 there is also total 2 chlorine and 6 fluorine. Similarly Br2 thrice F2 gives twice BrF3, and iodine plus thrice Cl2 chlorine in excess gives the iCl3, that means iodine trichloride. Now this is the bidirect combination method. Here no any that is the requirement of any other reagent or in that reactions. Only the two halogen combine and there is formation of interhalogenary compounds. Now come to the second method, reaction of halogen with interhalogen compounds. Now if we wants to prepare the interhalogen compound other than we have, then from which we have the interhalogen compound, from which we can prepare the other interhalogen compound, and they are only required what? Only one halogen and the any one interhalogen compound. Now see here, here is the bromine trichloride is here, but I want to prepare the bromine monochloride. So take the this interhalogen compound bromine trichloride and reacts with the halogen. So reaction of halogen with interhalogen compound. Reaction of halogen with interhalogen compound. That also gives the another interhalogen compound. We are seeing the methods of preparation of interhalogen compounds. So here is the preparation of this bromine with the bromine trichloride. It gives the bromine monochloride. Now in the same way, SH3- of halogen also that is give. Here SH3- of halogen. Here we prepare the SH- type of interhalogen derivative. Now let us see how the SH3- of interhalogen derivative is formed here. Now this BrF3, but we have this ClF3 first. Now from ClF3 we can prepare the BrF3, and this is the one of the halogen. Now only just here what we have to change, we have to change only the most electropositive halogen. Here is chlorine, here is bromine, and again we obtain the XH- type of another interhalogen compound also by this method. And there is a special method or special reaction for the preparation of this, specially this interhalogen derivative ICl3. We may be asked how the iodine monochloride is obtained. Now this is obtained from this perchlorate, potassium perchlorate and iodine. Now only here what change is there? This chlorine get replaced by this iodine. KiO3 is formed from KClO3. Remember that. And how we obtain this? This that is the most important interhalogen compound from this chlorine, which is replaced, and one of the iodine atom from this ICl. Now this is the special reaction. Now again there are some properties of interhalogen compounds. First one is the thermal stability. Now we are seeing the interhalogen compounds of the type XH- only. Now see here. Now this is the XH- type of the interhalogen. Now this is the most stable interhalogen derivative. Remember that in MCQ they may be asked which is the most stable interhalogen compound. This chlorine monochloride is the most stable. And which is the less stable? Bromine monochloride. Remember that. And these are in between them as the stability now decreases up to the bromine monochloride. Now hydrolysis of these interhalogen compounds, that is the interhalogen compounds of the type XH- only we are seeing. Now they are give the oxoacids. Oxoacid means, now this is the oxoacid of bromine. This is the oxoacid of iodine. Now see here, this BrCl bromine monochloride with water gives the hydrogen oxybromide. That is the acid. And HCl has the byproduct Now this is also the exact type of interhalogen reactive when reacts with water. Now we are the seeing the hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means reaction with water. But they give the oxyacid. That means they are acid, but oxygen is there in that. So here is the hydroiodic acid is formed. Here is the that is the hydrogen oxybromide is formed. Now disproportion or autoionization. Autoionization means they themselves get ionized or decomposed into the two different compounds. One is halogen and another is the intrahalogen compound. Now this is the five molecules of bromine monofluoride. It gives two molecules of bromine and one molecule of bromine pentafluoride. Only you can balance the reaction here. And this is we always see in the organic chemistry chapter, that is alkene or olefin. Olefin means oil forming. Alkenes, the other name of alkene is olefins. Now these olefins or alkene when gets added, or this monohalogen, intrahalogen derivative when added into that, the double bond converted into the single bond, and we obtain the geminal dihalide likes compound. The name of that compound is the C come first in alphabetically. So the name is chloroiodoethane. Remember that. Now these are the somewhat properties of this interhalogen compound. Now let us see some structures of interhalogen compounds. Now let us see some uses of the interhalogen compounds. Now generally the XH dash type of interhalogen compounds are such as iodine monofluoride is used to determine the iodine value of the oils. Now in oils there is the iodine. So to detect the iodine value, how many part per million iodine will be there in the oil can be detected by this iodine monofluoride. And again these interhalogen compound of the XH dash type are also used as for the catalyst for the oxidation of that is astaxanthin 3. For the oxidation of astaxanthin, the catalyst is used, which is the XH dash type of interhalogen. That may be CLA, para ICL, any interhalogen, but of the type XH dash only. Again, for the preparation of polyhalides. Now see here. This is the polyhalide that we prepare here in this method. This BrF3 is the polyhalide, that means more electronegative halogen. Now for that also XH dash type of interhalogen compounds are used. Now see the uses of X3 dash. Now first use is for the preparation of polyhalides here. Again the second is as the fluorinating agent. Why they are used as the fluorinating agent? Now most of the interhalogen trihalides, that is the X3 dash type, they have the negative ion, that is fluorine, into that. We know that. In the types, we also see some examples of XH3 dash. There is always a fluorine as the negative ion. So they are used as the fluorinating. Now this is very important. In MCQ, they may be asked which type of interhalogen compounds are used as the fluorinating agents. Now XH3. Now I tell you, already tell you, on each and every line there is the MCQ may be asked in the board examination, JEE, GA, NEET, etc. in this chapter. Now the third is the as the non-aqueous solvent. Now for it is also used as a solvent, but non-aqueous, that means water is not there. Now for example, this ICL3, it is very good solvent. BrF3, also very good solvent. They can dissolve the organic material into them and inorganic also, but they are non-aqueous because water is not there. So these are the uses.